Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. My name is Gigi and today we're going to be covering a project about clothespin wreaths. This project was introduced to me by the friends and family of the Painted Turtle and I fell in love with it. The artists absolutely love it and I hope that you'll enjoy it too. Here's some materials that you'll need for this project. You'll need some colored clothespins, so you can either dye them or buy them colored already, a wire wreath, usually about 10 inches, hot glue gun or crazy glue, and please be careful with the materials, and also some decorations as well. Before we dive into the actual project, I'm going to kind of break down on how you actually make a clothespin wreath. So if you're going for a two-colored wreath, you're going to start by putting a clothespin on the first two inner wires of the wreath. And then you're gonna alternate colors. So right here I have red and orange. I'm gonna go red, orange, red, orange, red, orange. You're gonna make sure that they're tightly, firmly on those first two wreaths. Otherwise it's just gonna completely go all over the place. Now once you hit this vertical bar here, you're just going to start on the other side of it. Go as close to the bar as you possibly can. And then you're just going to keep on going, filling it up. It should make a nice pretty line or a pretty circle in the inside with all the clothespins if they're hung on there correctly. They should not be loose or too tight. Now you're just going to repeat this around the whole entire way until you hit the end. I'm leaving a little bit of space there just so that way I can easily glue some big flowers there later on. For a little bit of added security on those the clothespins don't fly away, you can also hot glue the back of them. Now on to the project. So I want to put out a disclaimer, please be careful using a hot glue gun or any gluing materials. It's very important that you do this so you don't get burned or anything like that. If you're not comfortable with it, find somebody who is and that could help you. Once you've assembled all of your different materials and you have your wreath all done, now you can start decorating. So right now I actually am using moss and some fake leaves and we're gonna make a kind of nature inspired mushroom wreath. If you're going to be decorating your wreaths, it's really important to figure out what's going to be layered. So right now I'm kind of setting up the basis of what's going to be behind, what's going to be resting on top of it, and really just kind of getting that foundation set up. Also, it's important to work with your biggest pieces first. This way it helps kind of figure out where everything's going to be. So now that I have pretty much all the areas that I want covered, I'm going to go in and start adding the little details, putting moss in certain places that I want to kind of overlap and kind of bring forward and really give some dimension to this. So once you're done with your background, figure out which way you want it. You can twist it, you turn it, look at it, and really figure out which way you want to be the top, which way you want to be the bottom. Once you've decided on that, then you can start with your other decorations that are going to be going. So like the mushrooms, I'm just going to be putting those right on top and make them look like they're popping out from the moss. So right here, I'm kind of deciding where I want to nestle them, which areas look good. It's really important to plan before you start gluing, because once you start gluing, it's very hard to actually break it off and you might actually chip or break your decoration. And then I decided to put all of them on the bottom after just kind of playing around with them where they fit. I had one patch of the clothespins that I wanted to cover up, so I had a couple fake leaves left over from another project, and I just glued that right on there. Figured that would just add a little bit more foliage to it. To really give it that forest path kind of vibe, I also glued some little leaves so it looks like kind of little leaves are springing up from the ground or they've fallen from another tree, and really just overall kind of give you that nature sense. Thank you. and we're done. Thank you so much for joining me in this project. I really hope you enjoyed it. As always, stay happy, healthy, and hydrated. We'll see you next time.